In the last few months, there have been a ton of NVIDIA launches, but we wanted to narrow our focus a bit more and talk about affordable graphics cards. The GTX 1660 Ti and the GTX 1660 are both priced under $300, so that puts them in the same conversation as cards like the GTX 1060, the GTX 960, and of course, the GTX 760. So that and your comments in our GTX 1660 performance review video got us into thinking about this little fun video. If we took all of these 60 series cards from NVIDIA from the last few years and benchmarked them, what would the results look like? Or in other words, how much of a performance improvement would these newer cards provide if you're still holding on to a GPU that was once affordable, but is still, you know, almost half a decade old? Honestly, this video is more about satisfying our curiosity than anything else, so we hope that you enjoy this one. But first, let's take a quick look at our sponsor. The legendary Hyper 212 CPU cooler from Cooler Master now comes in this breathtaking matte black finish. The included Silencio 120mm fan delivers great airflow and reduced noise, plus you can pick up an RGB version of this cooler as well. Learn more about the Hyper 212 Black Edition and its RGB sibling down below. All right, so I don't want to drag this out for too long, so let's take a look at some of the cards I'll be using. To keep things simple, I'll be narrowly focusing on GeForce GPUs that have been launched between $200 and $300 to chart a possible upgrade path from 2013 until now. So this is the EVGA GTX 760 Superclocked, which was launched back in 2013 for about $265. So a bit more than the $250 reference version, but it had higher clock speeds. It was also a good replacement for the GTX 660 series. Then in 2015, NVIDIA launched the GTX 960 for $200, and it almost instantly became a hit since it cost less than the GTX 760 while offering more performance and double the amount of memory. Again, I'm going to use the EVGA Superclocked version since it ended up being pretty close to $200. NVIDIA started running into a bit of a price creep for their next generation since the GTX 1060 costs $250, but man, did it offer a huge jump in gameplay performance. In some cases, it was over 50% faster than the GTX 960. It did end up becoming one of the most popular GPUs of all time and still is at the top of Steam's hardware survey. So that covers the older cards that'll be put up against the GTX 1660 Ti and the GTX 1660. So let's get into the benchmarks, starting with 1080p. Right away at the start of these benchmarks, the GTX 960 gives pretty playable frame rates in many of the games. Its lower 1% times are good too, but as the tests go on, it starts to run out of memory capacity in games like Shadow of War, Warhammer 2, Witcher, and Wolfenstein. The GTX 760 is really starting to show its age though, especially since it only came with 2GB worth of video memory, and its architecture isn't optimized for DX12. I think a lot of people with this GPU ended up getting on the GTX 1060 wagon, but if you didn't, today's GPUs will be a massive upgrade, even if the rest of your system is a bit older. Moving on to 1440p, and it's pretty obvious that while the GTX 960 is still a decent card in some games, it's one-dimensional. There's just no way it can keep up at 1440p, though in some well-optimized DX11 games like Call of Duty and Overwatch, lowering some settings could still lead to over 60 frames per second. The GTX 760 though, it just struggled to 1080p, which means you can forget about 1440p unless the in-game settings are turned way down. I also want to explain that those fails in some charts was either locked up or simply wouldn't run, likely due to memory limitations. The GTX 1660 and the GTX 1660 Ti of course offer huge upgrades for the GTX 960, and especially this GTX 760. But like I said before, anyone with a GTX 1060 shouldn't even think about moving up to the newer cards since they don't offer enough of a performance boost. So far, the benchmarks didn't really show anything unexpected, even though it's great to see the GTX 960 still being able to deliver playable frame rates at 1080p. We can actually see why the GTX 1060 was so popular too. The performance difference between the 960 and the 1060 was just so massive in comparison to the 1060 and the 1660. But this all leads me to another question. With the GTX 1660 at $220 and its Ti variant going for around $280 and higher, which one of those is actually the best value? Let's start by looking at how much of an overall performance boost you can expect. Straight up, the GTX 1660 Ti and the GTX 1660 provide about twice the amount of performance as the GTX 960 at 1080p. Compared to the GTX 760, they offer literally the same frame rates as three or four of those cards. Sometimes even more. At 1440p, the newer cards really do pull away even further due to their higher amounts of video memory. I also want to bring up the fact that if you already have a 1060, don't consider upgrading right now to a similarly priced 1660 card. It's just not worth it. Now that I've set the stage, let's take a look at the value equation, since it's probably what matters the most to anyone who spends just $200 to $250 on a graphics card. Actually, from a value standpoint, it's pretty much even between the GTX 1660 and the 1660 Ti. The EVGA Black Edition cards that I chose go for around $220 and $280, so basically reference price points. And that makes the 1660 Ti 27% more expensive, but it offers somewhere between 25 and 28% more performance. So if you can afford one of these higher graphics cards, it's gonna offer you a perfectly linear frame rate increase for the higher cost. Another thing that you guys brought up in our last video is the GTX 1070. It isn't shown in the charts here, but if you can find one for $200 or less that hasn't been abused with countless hours of mining, that might be a good option, but buying one brand new is just too expensive right now. So there you guys have it. It's really amazing to see what 6 years of development has accomplished in the super popular $200 to $300 GPU market. If you're actually interested in comparing older GPUs or CPUs from the past to the latest generation, definitely let us know in the comments down below. I definitely had a lot of fun with this, and I can't wait to see what you guys come up with. I'm Yu with Hardware Canucks. Thank you so much for watching. Make sure to check out some relevant content over here. Subscribe to our Boot Sequence channel. I'm signing off, and I'll see you guys in the next one.